All right, so this was a show fight for Nai Khanomtom Day in Ayutthaya. And getting into the ring, that is Samart Payakurun, who is super famous. These are all Petyandi people on the VIP stage, and that's Dieselnoi towering above the announcer. And in the white shirt behind him is Chat Chai, who is WBC champion. So Dieselnoi and Samart are going to do a show fight. They fought way back in the day. They're both Petyandi fighters. So these are a bunch of, like, super famous, older generation people all getting into the ring together. And Petyandi is one of the biggest promoters in Thailand for a very long time. So this is all their promotion. So they have their golden age fighters there. So they have Sagat there as well. This was at the Nai Khanomtom Day festival, so the referee who just got in the Baran outfit was probably at the Y Crew ceremony earlier. I was super excited for this show fight. Even though it's a show fight, seeing these guys get in the ring together was just so unbelievably exciting. So they're basically just announcing all of these head honchos as people come in. So that's Somrock in the gray shirt. This guy is a Sorplunjit fighter, K, the guy, the big dude in the black shorts. He did a show fight afterwards. And the guy in the blue shorts right there is Pimpnamit. He did the show fight with the Sorplunjit fighter, and it was absolutely hilarious. It was very good. So even though Dieselnoi is absolutely immense, he keeps getting pushed farther back for this photo in the crowd because he's big, so people keep moving him and he kind of gets, like, crowded out for this photo. The guy in the black jacket with the red and blue that says Muay Siam, that's one of the biggest magazines in Thailand that covers Muay Thai. So he's taking photos for the magazine. You'll see it every fight, especially out in festival fights, but God, on TV, they do these things prior to fights, which are introducing the head honchos and, like, the VIP people and taking photos and talking about local government and stuff, and it takes forever. So this actually was pretty fast, given how long those things can take, but what was cool about it is that I knew so many of the people they were introducing, whereas normally when they're bringing in the head honchos of my fights, I don't know who anyone is. The guy in the pink shirt over there to the right holding the golden tray, he was my corner last year at this same festival. I didn't come with anybody, so they just gave me someone to work with. You can't see him now, he's behind people, but he'll come back out. His name's Nung. So you can see organizing people for photos, always a big thing. This announcer who's talking about everybody, he's on the left there, the little guy with the red shoes and a microphone. He's the announcer for a lot of fights. He travels around a great deal. And he interviewed me coming out of the ring with a bloody face once, like, stuck the microphone in my face and I was trying not to get blood on him. Countdown to the photo. So this stuff is usually very boring, like trying to get to the fight and doing all of the announcements and introductions and all that different stuff, but I was actually really amped during this entire thing. I was very excited because of this show fight coming up. So now you gotta get everyone out of the ring, and this is just how it happens in festival fights as well. Everyone exits the ring and the fight starts immediately. The music starts and you start doing your Ram Muay, like, straight away. There's Chat Chai in the white shirt and the glasses. And his fanny pack. What is he doing? Alright, so Dieselnoi is there in the left in the corner in the red shorts. They don't have any gloves. So they came out ready to do their fight and they had forgotten to get any gloves. Clearly their hands are not wrapped, but I was like, just do it without. You guys are fine. Somrock in the gray shirt in the middle there, about to come out on the right. Super famous. Coming through the ropes right there. That's Somrock Kamsing. Anytime someone does where you, like, turn your body and do an upward elbow from the side, everyone yells Somrock when they do that. He's famous for that. Here, Samart is coming over and, like, trying to intimidate Dieselnoi. They're friends. They're very cute together. Look how many men it takes to put gloves. How many people does it take to put gloves on a superstar fighter from the Golden Age? Like, 7. Look at them. Samart keeps looking across the ring at him. They're totally talking shit across a, like, 16-foot ring. That guy acted as referee later, the guy who ran over and just kicked Samart's corner. So the announcer is, like, giving background on these fighters, which is mainly for the younger people in the audience. Everyone knows who these guys are. God, Dieselnoi's so big. Look at him. So he's just going to do a little stretch out. He's just getting himself ready. Dieselnoi had heart surgery not that long ago, maybe like 1.5 or 2 years ago. So he has to be a little bit careful. He can't exert himself too much, but the dude has one level. Like, he does not go light. So look at him hanging over the ring. They're letting him know that it's only 2 rounds for 2 minutes and 3 minutes in between rounds. And they're trying to find a Mong Khan for him now. They didn't have gloves. They don't have a Mong Khan. They had to, like, yell to so many people to try to get the Mong Khan. They did this gesture for the Mong Khan for, like, 2 minutes. Trying to get it from someone who was at the glove table. I think they have loners. He's, like, throwing knees at his corner. Look at him lean over the ropes. He's such a man's man. He's like the John Wayne of Muay Thai. Still trying to get that Mong Khan. Keep in mind, this is a show fight. This is just two old Golden Age fighters who are friends, like, doing a little demo for the enjoyment of the crowd, and having a Mong Khan is super important. There we go. So this guy's important who puts the Mong Khan on Dieselnoi, but they actually got a second guy to take it off, who is also a head honcho. Now you get to see the Ram Muay of two absolute Golden Age legends. Sagat of Street Fighter fame had done just a Ram Muay prior to this. He went in and did his own very elaborate and beautiful Ram Muay, but I gotta say, Dieselnoi's was way more, like, earnest. Dieselnoi just doesn't mess around. Like, everything he does is towards the reality of fighting. He's such a stud. Samrock has a very nice Ram Muay as well. I'm sorry, not Samrock, Samart. Look at him go. See how he's, like, bouncing to the rhythm? He is taking this so seriously. Like, you don't mess around on a Ram Muay. You do the Ram Muay. He hits those bounces. He's so awesome. Samart had had a female fighter, earlier in the show, maybe like 3 fights ago. And I had actually, Pinu had gotten a phone call to see if I could fight her on this show, and they ended up not wanting me because I was too small, but it would have been really awesome to have me fighting against Samart's fighter prior to this, because Samart would be in her corner and Dieselnoi would be in my corner, and then they would fight each other later. It's so cool. I don't know what this referee is doing. He's like, get out of the corner. Dieselnoi's tired. He is so funny. They're giving him the smelling oil. They rub this oil on their palms and, like, stick it in fighters' faces. It kind of, like, wakes you up. And Samart always has this very serious look on his face. He's very serious all the time, but when he smiles, he's got these huge white teeth, so you can see it from really far away. It's totally just like a real fight where, like, one guy's Ram Muay takes longer, so the other guy has to, like, ignore him for a couple of minutes, do his stretches in the corner. Samart just kicked him down while he was doing his leg stretches. It takes Dieselnoi a long time to get up because he's like 20 feet tall. So they're getting the instructions not to foul. 2 minutes, 2 rounds, 3 minutes in between. So they're getting this super head honcho to come take Dieselnoi's Moncon off. This guy was sitting at the VIP area and he's the one who gave everyone their money. They said that there was a 2 million bot side bet on this fight. Here they go, out of the way. These guys are in their 50s, and they still have, like, total control over their kicks. Look at Diesel go! Go with the knees! People are doing hand gestures for the odds, like, 20 seconds into the fight. Dieselnoi don't care. You punch him in the face, he doesn't care. Look at him go. Look at his little shove off with the palm of his hand. Samart's laughing already. Dieselnoi is totally doing exactly what he tells me to do. You just teep and let someone bring their weapons out first, and then you come out later. Look at how long. Good God. Samart's just coming after him. Look at him laughing. Oh. Round one, take a breather. Look at them perform, like, being fighters. But you can't take that out of someone. They're totally, like, this is fun for us to see these legends, like, get in the ring together, but they actually fought. Like, they have the memory of their fights in their minds from just totally in the golden age of Muay Thai in these enormous stadia. Samart coming over to make sure there's gonna be a second round. He's like, you okay, old man? he's asking Pet Yindi whether or not this is gonna keep going. Alright, so this is Samart coming over. He's letting Dieselnoi know that they want him to knee and clinch, and he's telling them there's a 5,000 baht injection. That's why he's pointing to his shoulder. They call it an injection when you add more money to the gambling to, like, entice a fighter during a fight. He's swatting at the referee. Fixing of the shorts is super important. What Samart just did, that's like part of a fight. Key element there. So now Dieselnoi is coming forward. Oh, watch it. Beautiful. Look at those knees. They come up to Samart's face. Nice elbow. But here, now he's starting to grab. Go! He only grabbed him and held him for like 2 seconds, and it was so exciting. That's the end. It was like a 1 minute second round. Look at how happy. These guys have been friends for like 20 years, 30 years. So that's a draw. The 2 million baht side bet doesn't go anywhere. It was so awesome. I said this before, but it's like if you got to go see a show fight between Muhammad Ali and Smoke and Joe Frazier in Vegas or something. So now they get their fight bonuses. This guy coming in to give them their fight bonuses. Usually with fighters, you'd put it in their mouths because they've got their gloves on. That lady, very, very high up. She's a head honcho. She's an owner of a gym. I think she's the wife of the Pet Indie. I'm not entirely sure. There was a photo with her and Dieselnoi the day before the fight. He went over and was wearing a nice jacket at her house. They brought over this podium like they were going to give a speech or something, and then they just took it away. I don't know if they had their timing off or something. It was really cool, though, because this is Pet Yen D is a huge, huge promotion. They're always at Rajadamnern or Lumpini. And this is essentially just a festival fight. Like, they just set up the tent in the sport fields of the university out in Ayutthaya for Nai Khanomtom Day, and the feeling is exactly like a festival fight. It's in Thailand, in Muay Thai, a fight is a fight. Like, it's interchangeable where it is or how big the crowd is or anything. But if you look around how excited everyone is and they're all packed in, it's so hot. There's no space between people. And then they're bringing out the next show fight. That's Chat Chai again in the white. And I made a separate video of this. It was incredibly funny. These guys did not take it as seriously as Dieselnoi and Samart did. They're just coming out.
Alright guys, that was the last of the fight. So I'm gonna end this live.
I didn't get my face. Sorry.